My name is April. I'm in 7th grade at Mercer Middle School, and my piece is called Chocolates for You. 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3. Numbers, repeating with every beat from the drum set, never-ending sequences. Voices in harmony could be heard in the practice room, but at last, a final beat ended her harmony. Sweat began to roll down as she carried a grin on her face. She looked around at her bandmates and let a chuckle out. That was pretty cool for our first run, she spoke in a cheery but raspy tone. The other four members turned to her, smiles plastered on their faces.
Tomoe-chan, you seem sweaty. Do you need mocha-chan zag?
Tomoe couldn't help but laugh again and shook her head. She got up and placed her drumsticks down. Her hand went into her pocket and pulled a small handkerchief out of it. No thanks, I have my own. She quickly dried the sweat off and checked the time on her phone, 6:24. Tomoe let a sigh out and stood up. She went to the door and spoke in a low but reassuring tone. Sorry guys, I gotta go home now. I'll make it up tomorrow though. After her parting words, she left. Tomoe entered her house with a bag of groceries. Her movements were quick, but quiet as she went into the kitchen. She had a plan. It wasn't a big one, but she had one. She pondered on it for a while. Should she do it? She had no experience, but she wanted to do something special for the people who gave her something. Her hands reached into the bag and pulled out a few ingredients to make chocolates. She placed them on the counter and took a deep breath. She was overthinking it, but why wouldn't she? She had never made chocolates, and she had no experience. Perhaps an article would help? Should I ask Sugu for help? No, I have to do it on my own. A sigh escaped her lips. She looked up an article on how to make basic chocolate bases and began to follow the steps. How can such a simple sweet be so hard to make? She thought to herself. Eyebrows furrowed slightly. Her hands held a spoon, which was mixing a smooth texture for the chocolate, but it had a few chunks. She eyed them as she didn't know how to get rid of them, but allowed them to stay since it was her first time. After her mixture was smooth, she got her molds out. Another glance at the article helped her slowly pour some of the melted chocolate into the molds. She picked the molds up and placed them into the fridge to cool down. She had a lot of chocolate left, which allowed her to keep repeating the process until she got enough chocolates to give to everyone. That should be enough. I just have to wait for a while now. Maybe decorating bags and making notes is a good idea. Tomoe grinned and made her way to her room. It was perfect. Chocolates with the note as a simple thank you to her friends and the people giving her things. It was all simply perfect. Tomoe entered her room and got a pen from a box. She also got a few small papers to make notes before heading downstairs again. What should she write on them? A simple thank you? That would be too good. But it was too simple for her. Maybe a thank you to every person personally? That was too much now. A thank you dedicated to everyone? That sounded like something better. She sat down at the kitchen table, a stack of paper on the table and a pen in hand. Decorative bags were lying next to the paper. Her hand took a note and began to write on it. A thank you was written on it, thanking everyone who had done something for her. Tomoe spent a long time doing this, so long that she even forgot about the chocolates for a while, but she didn't stop until all of the notes were written on. Once all of them were done, she took the chocolates out of the fridge. They seemed great to her. She had spent a few hours decorating chocolates before carefully placing them into the bags. That should be good now. I just need to pass them out tomorrow. Maybe I'll ask for some help from someone tomorrow, she thought in her mind. Tomoe couldn't help but smile as she made her way upstairs. She entered her room and immediately flopped onto her bed, not bothering to change out of her current clothes. Despite having a lot on her mind, she fell asleep. She was excited for the next day.